Good Friday morning to you. Thanks so much for joining us on American Morning. It is the 15th of October. I'm John Roberts.
I'm Kieran Gentry. Glad you're with us. We want to get you caught up on what happened overnight. They're out of the mine, out of the hospital, and finally home. Several of the Chilean miners are back with their families this morning. One of them is talking about his time underground, how he was just 10 feet away from where the ceiling began to cave in. His incredible story just ahead.
Taking a stand against bullies, a young student sends a message to his classmates that it's not okay to be a mean kid. Now see how this young man's crusade is reaching beyond his classroom.
Also, some drama on The View. Joy Behar and Whoopi Goldberg storming off stage over TV host Bill O'Reilly's view of whether or not to build an Islamic center near Ground Zero. We're going to show you how the drama unfolded and what Barbara Walters said to everyone.
Up first, though, home at last. Three of the Chilean miners are back with their families this morning. We got some video from late last night of them leaving the hospital looking healthy and happy, still wearing those $450 Oakley sunglasses. Remarkably well after 69 days underground. Many more could be released today. All 33 may be out by the weekend. Gary Tuckman is following developments on the ground in Copiapó, Chile this morning.
After the 33 miners were rescued, they were required to go to a hospital for a thorough examination. Well, CNN has learned some good news. Several of them were released from the hospital on Thursday. Many more are expected to be released on Friday, and there's no major medical problems whatsoever. One miner does have a slight case of pneumonia. Two have dental issues, some have skin issues, but no major problems, and that is the very good news. We've also been told there's only one major complaint. That is from miner Mario Sepulveda. The second miner pulled out, and his complaint was, I don't want to be treated like a celebrity, just like a normal person. We come to you from Camp Hope, which is adjacent to the mine. This is where the family members were living, waiting for their loved ones. But they've cleared out now that the good news has occurred. Now, the miners are talking, some of them, and we have some very interesting video and audio to show you of one of the miners. This comes from a journalist named Jonathan Franklin, who provided us some excellent footage, an interview he conducted with miner number 28 right after he was rescued.
We were all waiting for that. We were all very thin. I lost 12 kilos. I was afraid that I was not going to meet the child that was on the way. It was the thing that most scared me. I think the worst thing is to pass 3, 4, 5 days without food, to know that there might not be any future.
He lost 12 kilos. That's about 27 pounds. Remember the terror that these men were living through. 17 days before anyone knew they were alive. Now they're all alive and well, being treated in the hospital, and we expect them all to be home shortly. This is Gary Tuckman, CNN, at the San Jose mine in Chile.
Communications strategist Robbie Voorhaus is going to join us at 6:40 Eastern to talk about the miners' newfound fame and whether or not they'll be able to adjust to their new lives. It's a story of hope and inspiration that captivated the world. Take a look back at the events surrounding the rescue of the 33 Chilean miners. Don't miss Countdown to Rescue, an AC360 special tonight, 10 p.m. Eastern.
Meantime, it was billed as the debate in the desert, but it was really something bigger than that, a snapshot of a nation divided, pitting the establishment against the upstart Tea Party movement. Harry Reid and Sharon Angle squaring off last night with the Senate Majority Leader fighting to keep his seat and fighting for his political life. Angle, the aggressor, called Reid a career politician who voted 300 times for tax hikes. Reid countered by painting Angle as extreme. The candidates sparred over everything from the economy to health care and immigration. And when Social Security became the topic, things got a little testy.
Senator Reid.
Mitch, thank you, and thanks to the Nevada broadcasters for arranging this. Growing up in Searchlight.
Good evening. Thank you, Nevada broadcasters and PBS, for sponsoring this event.
Senator Reid, you're up first. In the minds of many Nevadans, Senator Reid, your policies have allowed thousands.
Clearly, that was not the part of the debate
Boy,
we wanted
I've
to show you.
I've never seen such sparring in my
yes,
life.
Yes, that was
the fist
that was intense.
Fur was flying. wrong soundbite.
Well, we're gonna show you a little bit more about the part that actually did get testy. Aha! Let's listen.
Social Security is a promise we have to keep. It takes care of seniors in their golden years. That's why I work so hard to protect Social Security. I feel so strongly about this that I took on the President of the United States when he tried to privatize it, and we won that battle.
Man up, Harry Reid. You need to understand that we have a problem with Social Security. That problem was created because of government taking that money out of the Social Security Trust Fund. In 1990, you said it was stealing to use Social Security for anything but Social Security. And then you voted to take that Social Security money into the general fund where it could be generally used for generally anything.
We'll just leave it at that. By the way, they're in a dead heat.
Even up in the polls. Other stories new that we're following this morning, the Justice Department filing an appeal against